There are eggs happening, apparently. What happened while we were away? Have we been attacked by a space chicken who just laid giant laser eggs everywhere? Is this... Look at that thing. Look at those things. They're okay, apparently they're also ghost eggs. That's good to know. I'm glad that we have giant ghost eggs. Okay, that makes sense. That's just a little mobile. You can make that in arts and crafts. You know, that's... But why are they flying? What is that? It's like the strange orbs of light out in the desert. No, I don't like this. I don't like egg on my face. Oh my god, look at... That's a fountain of eggs! The eggs have gotten into the water mains! I mean, okay. Why are we doing Easter? What connection does this fantasy world have? What? I don't even know. I do not even know. Let's just get out of this crazy town and let's go kill some cute wildlife. Okay, killing wharf rats, that understands, you know, they carry the plague. You don't want the Black Death in Eorzea. Why do we have to kill ladybugs and tiny little lambs? Those just sound adorable. Why do we have to murder them with an axe? You are a sick man, Axe Master. A sick man, Aster. Okay, because we're getting experience. Fine. That's what I am being told right now. We're getting experience and a hot meal. I mean, such is the life of a wandering hobo, you know. Everything is a fight for survival. I love the Lalaville thing. It's cute. This isn't anywhere close to a wharf. No. I want to speak with your supervisor, game. Is that even a rat? Looks like a kangaroo. Oh my god, look, it's a cute little eyes. It's like a kangaroo anteater thing. And we're gonna kill it. I'm gonna kill it with an axe. I hope you're proud of yourself, Wandering. I hope you sleep soundly at night. Oh, good. You've gone up a level. Great. You can kill things more efficiently now. Look at that. How could you kill it? It's the size of a cat. I want to take one home. Keep it as a pet. It can sit on my head. Oh, Clam. No. It just wanted to farm some aphids. Or does it eat the aphids? And ants farm the aphids. I don't know. I only know this from Pixar movies and the DreamWorks movies that ripped them off. And now I'm imagining all those ladybugs talking with Dennis Leary's voice. Oh, God. It's doing an angry thing. It's spreading out its wings to look bigger. Oh. It's adorably dead. Are there no more lambs for you to slaughter in this area too, Clam? Or you done murdering God's precious creatures? I mean, seriously, Clam, come on. Just, do you not have enough murder left in you? Why did I even take this job, I wonder? Hey, don't get fresh, delivery moogle. I see where that head is going. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Moogles are supposed to hide in trees and avoid contact with outsiders. And we're leprechauns, apparently. Why even would they agree to carry about letters? Why indeed? And if I had my way, I'd be curled up in the canopy of a nice oak. Oh, the beautiful Moogled with a rainbow-colored pom-pom. Oh, dear. I'm so sad. Please, just let me bury my head in your bosom there. Oh, yes. Oh, that's so nice and soft. But no, the moon had to go and drop down from the skies because all that terrible commotion. Aetherites were shattered and the link pearls rendered useless. And, you know, we managed to fix all of that within, you know, within 5 years. And now it's like nothing ever happened, so I don't even know why I'm mentioning it. But, you know, the little horn ones, I don't know which ones those are. I know the little ones, I don't know any horns. The efforts to assist them by delivering messages. At first, we were right wary of showing ourselves, worried that one of you might catch and skin us, like you do for every other forest furry. Oh, phrasing, Moogle, phrasing. But once we saw how much we were appreciated, we knew we'd found our new calling. And I personally promised to try and not read any along the way. Although, man, I could just tell you some juicy shit. Look what we have here. 3 new letters have arrived for you. Oh, yes, these are the backer rewards you get. You play Final Fantasy long enough, you get new toys. Oh, we have a minion. We're well on our way to becoming the evil overlord we all knew we could be. Oh, ooh, what's that? The wind-up cursor minion. That's look at the little Lollipop just coming up to you like, you're so tall. You're so tall. You're so tall. You're so tall. I could climb you like a tree. I don't even know what I could add to this. I'm just so glad I was here for this moment. I mean, okay, she's probably looking at the Moogle, but not at you. But come on. Come on. We all know what she was thinking. We're all thinking it. I mean, I assume that Lala was a she. Mostly by the hair. It's very difficult to tell. Almost no sexual dimorphism with a Lala. It's just potato, potato. Okay, yes, the Aetherite, a really unique function. I like it because you can, once you link up to them, you can just travel to important points all around the city without having to walk. Unless you're in the Rogues Guild, which for some reason doesn't have an Aetherite nearby. I mean, I guess a rogue wants its secrecy or something. I don't know. Everyone knows it's there. There's no reason not to have it. I don't think I've ever been down here. I didn't even know this was here. What? Oh dear, what have we got into? Is this a drug deal gone bad? Get out of there, Wandering, or someone's going to run you over with a Pontiac Aztec. I don't know what these things are. I'm going to assume that's a Skaven there, and that's a Dragonborn, and they're talking with this Goliath, and what do you do when you see someone in a drug deal with a tiny little rat man and a monster from Power Rangers? Oh, okay. Yeah, good for you, ladies. That was better than it could have been. I mean, we just saw a drug deal. I was like, oh Lord, did we run into a pimp? I cannot tell if they're wearing pants or not. That's a poorly chosen die. Lord Sidekick. Okay. Lord Sidekick? This is why people shouldn't be allowed to name themselves. I'm sorry, I'll try not to be distracted by the funny names I see, but they... Come on, people. You know, I think we should be grateful that the Aetherite crystal isn't a giant Easter egg. Oh yes, just leave a bunch of eggs out on the floor, because, you know, eggs aren't fragile. Eggs won't be hurt if anyone steps on them. I mean, I hope they're at least boiled, because it is very warm out here. Things are going to rot. That plaza is going to smell like just a bunch of skunks all took a Dutch oven. Wait, Animus, go back to that. Turn around a second. Animus Dominus. See, this is the kind of shit I'm talking about. Okay, good. Now we have to just kill a bunch of adorable little baby sheep. Oh my god, look at that! They're just cotton balls with legs! Clammy, no! Oh, okay, this one wants to start some shit. Bring it down. Fleece butt. The attack is called Fleece Butt. Oh, good, good. We get college credit for that. Great. I'm sorry. I just cannot get over Fleece Butt. Oh yeah, you leveled up again. I'm sure we'll keep leveling up, you know, twice in the next 30 minutes for, you know, as long as we continue the game. That just makes sense. Are we doing this? We doing this whole thing? All right. So a flock of sheep bitten by diseased bats has grown frenzied and is charging at full speed toward the Zephyr Gate. The infected creatures cannot be allowed to enter the city, so they must be driven off or put down. Yeah, because no way that the city could deal with rabid sheep. They don't have... Do they not have, like, a gate they could put up? You know, they have, like, some level 30 guards at the door? Why would we have to send out the level 1s? Is it like when you're playing XCOM and you run out of good dudes, so you have to level up your crappy dudes? And, well, we have a lot of sheep to kill. Just gonna be doing this for a while. I mean, this is Wandering Eorzea. I'm your VJ, Captain Sarcasm, which I forgot to mention at the beginning of this video because I'm a professional. And we are killing a bunch of just adorable sheep. I mean, look at their cute little eyes. Look at them staring up at you so trustingly. They know you'd never hurt them. They know only a monster would do that. They know you'd have to be just the worst kind of person. Oh my god, look at their noses! I didn't notice they got like little turned up Who Down in Whoville noses. Like tiny little rhino, tiny fluffy little rhino sheep. Oh my god, you leveled up again! Just from that fate! Oh my god, you are killing it, Clam! You are literally killing a lot of things! Now go and kill that big thing. I think you can take him. Yeah, he's only like 3 times your level, and the size of a bus. Go on, you coward. Oh my god! Oh shit, she's actually doing it! Holy shit, look at the teeth! He's got 3 rows of teeth like a great white shark! Oh. Nope, this is... I thought you had him for a minute. You died. I take no responsibility for that. You know. I mean, I may have peer pressured her into it, but it was her choice. Oh, wow, they're everywhere. No one has any dignity left. You are returned to me, a different woman! Already your face shows a harder cast, a realization of the slaughter of which you are capable. But there is much training to be done before you will wield the axe to its fullest potential. Learn well your lessons, build your strength, and make of each swing an instinctive act. You shall have this hunting log to aid you in the endeavor of slaughtering defenseless cute animals. Pages are marked with tiny adorable drawings done by elementary school students who had no idea what they would be used for. Now, there are, of course, myriad methods by which you might improve your techniques, but when the way forward is not readily apparent, the log provides a reliable source of challenges. Trust the log. The log loves you. The log is God. Every blow of your weapon will clear another step towards the mastery of the Marauder way. Implacable, relentless, such must be your momentum on both the practice grounds and the battlefield. Now what do we get here? Oh good, we get some steak. That's nice. At least we get a meal out of it. Oh, we get money. That's not... Is that money or experience? I can't remember. Gnad. Gnade? Oh well, she needs you to do stuff. An alarming number of citizens have gone missing of late, though I suspect you've already heard the rumors. It is essential that we ascertain their safety. To this end, I've prepared a list based on reports from our citizens. Would you be kind to deliver it to my college and bulwark heart? Do you not have anyone who can do this? Do you not have, I don't know, any page? We just spoke with the messenger Moogle. Anyway, take it to this woman named Nidelica. That's an actual name. My thanks in advance, friend. I mean, okay, there's a well-established courier system here. Oh God. I'm sorry, are we in a pod person situation? Are these eggs going to hatch and then replicate whoever's nearest? Are we going to wind up with a chocobo running nearby with a Rogadane's face on the end of its neck? I am not ruling out anything in this egg-tastrophe. Eggpocalypse. Armageddon. There we go. I knew I'd find one. So is there a main quest going on? I feel like there should be. I feel like we have something we should be doing. Okay, we have nothing better we should be doing. Oh my God, Tuxedo Mask! Look at him! Look at him just standing there being completely useless. Oh, wow. See, the honeymoon's not over for this guy. And this right here is the famous Limsa Lamimsa lump of rock. The crow's list will carry you up and down the tower as fast as the crow flies. That's not what that expression means. You only need to speak with Grandfar and tell him where you need to go. Welcome to Limsa Lamimsa. If there's too many words on screen. If there's hot you would like to know, feel free to... You've got something for me? A missing persons list? I'm not sure I follow. A disturbingly long list of people who have gone missing in recent moons. Thanks for bringing the list. I'll be sure to memorize these names. If any of the missing persons reappear, you can count on me to spot them. I'll just look for the name floating above all of their heads. Most folk enter the city via the Zephyr Deck, which means they must pass through Bulwark Hall. That's why I'm on constant watch here and undercover, so as to keep an eye out for the suspicious activity. Okay, sure. This is a real police operation going on. I've been doing this for so long, I've become a pretty good judge of character. If there's shady characters skulking about, you can rest assured I can pick him out. So, okay, these two pink-haired cat girls are the magical TSA. I'm sure they're very effective. Oh, sounds like you're already in the Yellow Jacket's good graces. You truly are a model violent hobo. Why, you're a credit to your people. Do you think you could do me a favor? See, I'm supposed to go and fill up all the streetlights with oil. Do you not have people for this? God, what is unemployment in this city like? Thanks to the business of missing people, I can't simply up and leave my post. If you could tend to the street lamps in my stead, I'd be eternally grateful. Wink, wink. Big, strong, rogue a dame like you. Oh, and when you're finished, please fetch some more oil from Sisipu, in the Fisherman's Guild. We're running low here, and she has care of our stores. Do you... Alright, fine. Fine, legendary warrior of light, just everyone's errand girl. That's fine. This is the legend we are crafting for ourselves. Fuel use light the street lamps of Limsa Lamimsa. It reeks of fish. Careful, don't get any of that on your face. Oh dear. Oh man, just soaked right in completely. Oh God, they're putting an egg minefield in front of the lamp. Oh, no. No, it's not even there. I mean, I'll give the design this. What am I doing? Talking about the design of the street lamps. Oh. Okay. Okay, now we've encountered the prostitutes. All right. Good to know that's a possibility in this world. Look, come on. Dude, she doesn't really like you. She's just doing a job. Come on. Come on, you're a sailor. That one's already lit. Oh, come on. I mean, that's just disingenuous. Also, I like that apparently just pouring this thing of fish oil onto an open flame. That's real good, Wandering. That's going to work out good for you. Some of them just look like bugs. Like, like those giant ladybugs, but with different patterns, just waiting for someone to come near, and then you like jump out, bite their foot. You're doing what? What am I to do with that girl? She got the nerve to ask me for work, and twaddling trap about her savings, only to foist it on the first venture it comes along. I'm glad that this redneck potato has the same opinion about this that I do. Again, sorry, apparently this is female, I'm guessing? It's, again, hard to tell with Lala. Being young and pretty does not give you license to shirk responsibility. She'll get her oil all right. Peace of my mind to boot. Another egg! I hope there's some kind of mission for going out and finding all of them. There's always just going to be one hidden where nobody even knows exists. The calamity really knocked the wind out of the fishing industry's sails. But fisher folk are starting to return to the seas once more. Oh, it's past time I did the same. But before I can put out to sea again, I'm going to need a bigger boat. Our guild's always commissioned Naldic and Bob and Steve for its crafts. But they are beastly busy these days. So I'm asking you to do it. I want you to take this plywood and this hammer and this box of thumbtacks, and you're going to build me a boat. Then we're going to take two of every animal and put it on here for when the dragon returns and wipes out all life from this sinful earth. I've run out of things to say about eggs. I mean, I assume based on their size, you know, they're chocobo eggs, which... No, that adds nothing. I have nothing to add. Okay, so apparently we're actually what we're really doing is we're going over to the Armorer's Guild. We're going to see the Armorer about a boat. I cannot follow the logic here. Yeah, just leave them with all the red hot metal. Oh my god, look at her! Oh my god, she's amazing! She's a fucking... Look at this badass! Looks like she just stepped out of the Matrix! Wow! A new boat for the Fisherman's Guild? Well, I'm afraid now isn't the best time. You see, we have recently taken on a commission for a galleon. Now, this task alone has all our hands full. But, hey, look, man. Look, girl, I'll see what I can do. Well, the fisherman has long been one of my best clients. I'd be loath to disappoint sis. Okay, seriously, are you going to forge a boat? Are they made of metal here? Are you just going out in a fucking tin bath? It may take a while, but I shall endeavor to have her boat ready in a timely fashion. Okay, so we can get an eye... Ooh, we can get an eye patch. You know, You've never been to Piratropolis until you get a fancy new eye patch. You get your name sewn into it like the Mickey Mouse hats. Whoa, are you in need of some trifling task to pass the time? Well, then I have just a job for you. Balderon's offering a reward to any adventurer who slays at least 5 warfrets. Oh good, we're doing this again. There's no shortage of the pests lurking outside the Tempest Gate, which is not on nor anywhere near a wharf, so this makes perfect sense. Better hurry, or they're gonna run out of vermin. We really don't have anything more important to do. I could have sworn there was at least a main story quest going on. I mean, all right, Clam, this is your world, and I'm just projecting my thoughts directly into your head. And yes, I can read your thoughts. Oh, my... Clam, honey, but back away. Back away. What? Oh, God, that's even worse. Oh, my God, she got ear holes from it. Like, it's like Sheldon's... No, which one? Yeah, it's like Sheldon with his legs poking through. Oh, good, Lord Sidekick is still here. That's something we needed more of. Oh, there it is, the main story quest. And, okay. Well, I mean, good to know what kind of attitude we're taking to this whole legendary hero thing. It's always nice to know where you stand. Okay, so we can see here that things we have to kill for a quest have a little queue over them for John Delancey. You know, you can see this when you die, but they have that little echo symbol above it, which means they're actually there. When we kill them, we get bonus experience after we kill enough of them because they're on our hunt list. And it's really good because it makes grinding more rewarding than usual. It gives you, gives you the normal XP you get from grinding, as well as special hunting XP. You level up like several times faster going after hunt creatures than just trying to grind whatever comes your way. But then again, but then when you think about it, it's just like this. It's just like a whole collection of quests that say, okay, go out and get 5 bear assholes and bring them back here, or go to the Philistine camp and bring back 100 foreskins. I mean, it's efficient, but yet it's also just doing the same old tired shit from every MMO in the world. But it's doing it in a new way, and that makes it better. So you slew a few rats, huh? Well, good on you, lass. This guy comes through the other day, pops his huge sack size of a bleeding goobbue on the counter, saying any man who can slay rats can have something from within. I looked inside, though. Just full of cow turds. Well, who has a whole sack full of cow turds? Anyway, when you ask why, all he says is the damn noise they make when scurrying about is driving him insane. You ask me, he's already a bit touched. Something tells me the poor lad will never find peace. Okay, so crazy person just gave a sack full of, like, donations for the thrift shop. And says, here, anyone who kills a bunch of rats can have these. Oh, okay, pink. Pink is not a good color for an eye patch. I mean, at least you get the gray skin, so it's not like blending in completely with your face. Bateron, proprietor of the Drowning Wench, wants you to lend a hand at Summerford Farms. Still in Limsa, are you wandering? How do you fancy a trip outside the city walls? Want you to visit an orchard by the name of Summerford Farms. Ever hear of it? The owner, Stalewyrn, is an old friend of mine. He's got himself a crew of mostly reformed pirate types, if you can believe that. And he's been trying to bring a bit of life back to the fields after the calamity ruined the soil. He mentioned needing another hand or two, and I thought you would be perfect for going out tilling crops, picking up pig shit. So I told him you would just be happy to come do manual labor for him. So make sure you do a good old job or he'll kick your ass out. It's not hard to find. Just go northeast. It's literally the only point of interest in that direction. So this guy, he met you maybe, what, a day, a week ago, and he's just already obliging you to do cheap menial labor at some asshole's farm full of a bunch of, air quotes, reformed pirates. That's, you know, maybe the main quest isn't so good. Maybe we should just stick to doing random shit around for people we meet around town. Going back for something? What? Or not? Wandering is very much like a cat, you know? She can never decide if she wants to be in or out. On to Summerford. Summerford? Sumerford? Sumerford, the Ford of Sumeria. Just think, only 20-something levels until you get a chocobo. And that's just something to look forward to. Oh, look at that. It's Death Mountain in there. Quick, if we rush towards it, we can fight Ganon before we go to any of the dungeons. Oh, look at these. Look at these little guys. Oh, my God. Look at them. They got little Whoa. They're just adorable, tiny little turnip men who are... Oh, hey. Is that blackface? Is that one in blackface? I mean, not cool. Okay, yeah, let's kill them. Let's kill them all. It's amazing you could theoretically do this whole game in first person. I mean, you shouldn't. You'll die. A lot. But you could. If you're crazy. You know what? Those are adorable and hilarious, but I'm slightly okay with killing them. It's they're even funnier when they die. Ha ha ha. Wandering, don't go into the bee cloud, Wander. Don't. You can't kill bees with an axe. That's not how anything works. What did I just see? How did that happen? Wandering, stop antagonizing the bees. Not the bees, Wandering. Not the bees. Oh God, this game's in my eyes. They're in my eyes. Conmar. Well, no work ethic in these washed up lackeys. Too busy living in the past to make a difference in the present. He seems fun. He seems like a fun person. Well, I hope they put their pirate muscle in good use out in the fields. I failed to reckon on their loafing pirate bones. Look at him. He's got a jaw like Bruce Timm drew him. What? Yeah, he's got a chin like Robert Zadar. I don't know what you're insinuating with that speech bubble. Has he got the gout? Has he got chewing tobacco in his face? Is that it? He's got... Okay, it's clearly... They got a big lump of chewing... A char right in his face. Which... I mean, I think that's just the way his chin is, because holy shit, his chin takes up nearly the entire width of his face. You see, don't get too close to him. He could bite your whole head off. Seriously, you could just swallow a Big Mac in one bite. Oh, bestiality. Oh, it's hilarious. Apparently she thinks you're going to steal her man, and... I mean, damn, I don't know what she's got to worry about. I would fear for my life if I ever thought... Okay, yeah. Those are some... That was a very succinct explanation. I appreciate the body of evidence you gathered. You know, I would love if, like, maybe on like a roll of d20 on a 1, they just start beating the shit out of each other. And we're right back to where we began, having accomplished nothing. Here we go, gotta go up, Clam, up. Bird drag? Well, Vanuscan oranges are chock full of nutrients and sweet tasting to boot. They're vital to keeping scurvy at bay, too. Next time you're at your local supermarket, pick up a bushel of Vanuscan oranges. This message brought to you by the Orange Council of Vanuscia. 50 years of farming have taught me the songs of the soil and the words of the wind. You, Clam, can you paint with all the colors of the wind?
You must be the adventurer Belderon promised to send along. Wandering Clam, wasn't it? Yep, that's apparently your name. You honored his words, that's a good start. I'm Stalewind. The old bastard is Belderon, like they called me, which you named because of my constant flatulence. It's all silent but deadly, but you can smell them, can't you? Yeah, you just let that waft. You get that, let that waft. A good number of the lads and lasses working here once terrorized the high seas. And if you're wondering why I employ these scrags, well, they used to crew my pirate ship. The calamity did for our ship like it did so many others, and I was sore wounded into the bargain. I had to feed myself and my crew somehow, and Admiral Myrtle Wibbs' initiative to get us landlocked buccaneers working the fields seemed too fine an offer to refuse. Oh, who's this asshole? Well, turns out you can take the pirate away from the sea. Can't take the sea away from the pirate. A lot of my blokes just never took the tin in the soil, you see. And sadly, the botanists I called in to train them have been wringing their hands in black despair. Dude, that's racist. So much work piling up. I need a tougher soul like you to step in and help where it's needed.
Okay, so we're going to get... Ooh, we get fancy shoes. That's good. Good. We need a new pair. They go with our murder stomping gear. My god, you leveled up. You've leveled up like 5 times already. Everything you get is just going to be pink, isn't it? They're going to turn you into the Barbie Deluxe Rogadame. It's pink! Get a little uncomfortable getting this close. Stale wind. Well, I'm going to stick with the farting joke anyway. He wants to inspect your equipment and thereby gauge your readiness for the tasks he has in mind. Never mind to set you to a task, Calm. But before I do, need to be sure you're properly kitted out. Pirates don't care to parlay with dandies, whatever those damn movies might have taught you. It might be well the ones here trading their cutlasses for coulters, but they're still rogues at art, no matter how much Ann Coulter they read. I know a solid set of gear when I see it. Come back when you think you're more suitably equipped.
Okay. I'd like to point out, I first played this as a mage, and one of the better items you get is a cloak that takes up your body and your head slot, and it's better than the standalones for either, but it won't let you do this quest while you're wearing them because I don't know, the scripting is fucked. So you have to go out and buy stuff that's worse than what you have, so that you can convince him that you've got good enough equipment.
Oh wait, our eye patch is as good as a helmet?
I mean, okay, why not?
Halbergion?
So we got a hempen tabard, some fingerless leather gloves. I mean, this isn't like the hipster starting pack. A Saruel? That's... Okay, some of these have to be made up words.
Oh, now it's a true RPG. You know it's a true RPG when you're dressed like a D-list character drawn by Jack Kirby.
Oh, but look at that. You got a shield. It's an actual physical shield part of your armor. It's a booby shield.
Well, I mean, now you're less likely to steal that pirate girl's man. You know? I mean, not unlikely. It could still happen. It'd be like really easily. But
I know. And it's going to be so many levels until you can die stuff too.
You're going to be stuck with what the game gives you.
That's the thing, there's only one person in the whole game who can teach you how to die stuff, and you know, if you're not in the starting area he is, you're just out of luck.
Oh yeah, let's have a look at you, shall we? Come on, turn around. Show Grandpa Steelworm what you got.
Well, even if you're going to be this covered, I won't feel any guilt.
throwing you to the sharks. Serious wild buccaneers are an ornery lot. They rage in love for the sea and care little for the laws of the land. They respect strength. And by the looks of you, I'd say you'll have little trouble getting their attention.
Ooh, shiny new axe! I mean, are we still using bronze weapons? Where are we? Are we in Babylon? Is Gilgamesh going to show... Okay. That one was a stupid question. I mean, the bronze is pretty. It's a very nice metal. Oh my god. Wait, go back. That... I think... That's like their equivalent of the creepy horse mask. Look at it. They're going to be all... In 1,000 years, when someone invents YouTube, there's just going to be all kinds of people making videos and reaction GIFs wearing that mask. I want one of those masks now. I want that to be my new Facebook photo. Real life, true fact? Clam just bought one. The horse mask, not the chocobo mask. Those things don't exist yet. Not until we get our Kickstarter going. Anyway, we don't have a quest right now, do we? Shit, I think we forgot to get a quest. Are we just going to kill stuff? I'm good with killing stuff. So, once again, this is Wandering Eorzea, and, I mean, the wandering part is a lot more accurate than it normally is right now. I, as always, am your VJ, Captain Sarcasm, and for a change, we're playing with Wandering Phrasing. We're not playing with Wandering Clam, Wandering Clam is playing as herself, but we're... You know what? No way of salvaging that. None at all. Fizulmi? I'm sorry, that sounds like an alien name from the Legend Star Wars book. This is Bulwark Hall, the lowest level of the mizzenmast. In case you aren't familiar with the nautical term, a bulwark is a plating that prevents waves from swamping a ship's decks. Now, you replace waves with hordes of howling beastmen, and you'll get an idea of the purpose for which this chamber exists. Racism! That's what... I like that you can see, like, occasional beastmen just in the city. Is that just tokenism? Is that... Oh my god! Oh my god! That's so tiny! Is she human, or is she one of those dragon people? I can't even tell... Yeah, definitely dragon person. I think. I don't even know. And that human woman's... I think it's a human. She's almost as... No, it's an elf. Okay, that makes more sense. I mean, an Elizen and a Hure. A Hure. It will never not sound like just a cheap, you know, Chinese knockoff of a human. Though Marauders are renowned for their raw destructive power, I prefer to focus my energies on developing effective stratagems. The doctrine of overwhelming force that many follow has not always been successful, you see. Ancient Nim, in particular, is said to have defended itself from numerous invasions, despite possessing only a token force of mariners and mages. She talks like she's on a Discovery Channel show. Indeed, I believe there is much we can learn by studying the military tactics of old. I hope one day to persuade my brethren of this fact, so that we might grow as an organization. Are there any other Lalafell in the hit things with the big fuck off axe guild? Because, I mean, I don't see any, but I suppose one of them could be like behind a table or a stack of Stephen King novels. Is that just affirmative action going on? Or is she secretly like the most badass one? She is, you know, that's what she is. She's figured out that when you use an axe, your body is the fulcrum, and she's just made... Oh my. Sorry, I forgot what I was going to say for some reason. He's implying they were aiming for the genitals. Oh god, I like that the official uniform there just has the deepest V you could imagine. I swear, is Ricardo Montalban the head of the Yellow Jackets? Should I be doing that voice now?
Axemaster Wernzoen wishes you to experience the traditional Marauder training method.
Wandering, you approach me with a Marauder's stride, determined, unswerving, and bereft of the hesitation that marked our first meeting. I am pleased! The time has come for you to begin a new stage in your training. Now, what sets the axe apart from the gladius or the dagger? Is the raw, unstoppable destruction wrought by its thick, heavy blade. And that overwhelming power can only be properly directed by extraordinary physical strength. And then he just looks over at the Lalafell in the corner and shakes his head. Oh, what? I make up on point, I guess, but you look like a raccoon from the negative dimension. Thus we come to the core of this day's lesson. Such strength as a Marauder must possess is developed through traditional method, passed down through the Armstrong family for generations. A method that you too shall be taught to employ. Present yourself to Broenbar in the practice area downstairs, and he shall instruct you further. So yeah, she was like 7 foot tall, red hair, wearing like a bright green shirt and bright red pants. Wait, go back there. Go back to that egg. I like that they have just a big picture of guns here, and it would be like several years before any of the player characters could actually use guns. That's some good foreshadowing right there. Of course, a bunch of NPCs already have guns, so I mean, why do they get special treatment? They're not paying for this.
Oh, the Axemaster told me you'd be on your way. My name's Broenbar. Good it is to meet a new Marauder. Now, we axe wielders.
He's far too dignified for that accent. I apologize. But I'm going to keep going with it.
Now, we axe wielders build our strength and control by splitting boulders. Oh, he's too right. Our traditional method involves smashing a rock with your axe. Yeah, go out, kill a fucking rock. Can't use any old swing. Need to hit the rock just right. Rock gave a fellow Marauder's waiting just outside the Zephyr Gate. With a bridge over the Rogue River. She'll tell you how it's done. She will.
Ooh, somebody's interested in us for their free company. Wait, Antipater? Oh no, that was the Antipope. Good thing you avoided that. You could have been excommunicated. Let's stay in this building for a second here. It's called the Seventh Sage, but I mean, it's just this whole tower is just one herbalist shop and a crossroads and more eggs, of course. But okay, no. Moving on. Yes, moving on. We're getting. Stop. No. Get a room, you two. For all that's good and holy. This game is a filthy mind. Glad one of you wrote me into it. There's nothing but perverts in this world. Or is it just because we're in the town that's like 90% sailor per capita? Sweet Nick's rosy cheeks? Oh my god. Sushi roll? Over to the right. There we go. Anabrosophocles? Oh, you people are all just... You people are wonderful. This is the best community. you know what should happen? They should make the Easter Bunny into a primal. They get a special seasonal-only event where you and like 20 other people just team up and kick the Easter Bunny's ass. Oh my god, everyone is so tiny compared to you. It's hilarious. Well, somebody migrated over here from Dark Souls, apparently. Oh, strawberry shortcake! Oh my god! I mean, I don't know what that is. I didn't watch Strawberry Shortcake religiously when I was a young boy. Shut up. Okay, yeah, there's always one that's just so far out of your way. There we go. Once you tune with all the Aethernite crystals in the city, you can get a special bonus that allows you to just travel to any of the gates. All vessels that make use of Limsa Lamensis port must submit to a cargo inspection and pay the duties incurred. Please direct all inquiries and complaints to the front desk of Malavan's Gate. Thank you for flying with us. You have no choice but to fly with us.
What door? That door opens automatically for you. Look, see? You don't even need...
He's just standing outside the Walmart, watching all these people go through the sliding doors. And like, how do you open this? Okay, so they want us to hit rocks with our axe. I kind of would feel that she was going to ruin the axe.
Greetings, lass. You ready to split some stone, are you? I got three nice hard rocks for you to build up a sweat on.
Raising, lady. Praise.
Don't try nothing fancy now. Just hit him with a good, solid, heavy swing.
With capital letters. Right? Because, I mean, apparently there's different ways to swing an axe. And, like, I mean, I'm not going to deny there's... I'm thinking too much about this. It's a video game. Of course, one way to swing an axe does twice as much damage as all the other ways to swing an axe.
That's just how it works here.
That's the way to do it, lass. Now you got the idea. Why don't you take it up a notch and use your skull sunder to break up a few more?
Just keep breaking rocks endlessly until you die or the universe ends.
So, will she somehow know if you don't use the right trick? I mean, how would she figure it out? I bet she's not even looking. Oh, something bad's going down behind us. I love that we can just see their speech bubbles as they all rush in and die. Oh, you can see them in the background. They're fighting those tiny mandagoras. I don't know how you say that word. Yeah, you see them fighting a losing battle against vegetable pygmies, and you're just like, nope, none of my business. You're the hero Eorzea deserves.
Oh, I can see you're a natural. Now my head's still ringing with the sound of cracking boulders. Take yourself back to Axe Master Wernzwin and let him know you're ready for something harder.
Just, is it me? Am I the pervert here? Am I the only one seeing it? I mean, before we got this, he just would not stop talking about his thick, heavy blade. And, okay, I know an axe isn't typically the most phallic of weapons, but, you know, any port in a storm, okay? Can we see what's on the big rock? Okay, no. Well, I meant, the whole thing, you know, the whole seal. It's interesting to me that the seal of the city is like a more Viking longboat type of deal, not a traditional pirate ship. I think it's a good environmental storytelling. It really speaks to the age of this city, or at least, you know, to the kind of ancient tradition it's trying to link itself to. Boring history talk.
Oh, Axe Master, I've come back and I'm ready for something harder.
Papa Rama? Rana? Quit moving so fast. Papa Rama, all right.
Has the training loosened your muscles and focused your mind, Wandering? An urgent request for help has arrived from the Red Rooster Stead, and I have chosen you to respond. It appears a hostile group of megalo crabs has unwittingly elected itself as the next test of your prowess.
You know, I used to play bass for megalo crab.
As this is your first outing on official Marauder duty, you shall be accompanied by a veteran conjurer of the name Solquib. She awaits you on the floor below. May devastation follow in your wake. Hooah!
Are you inter... No, come on. You're already in the Marauder's Guild. He should know that. He runs the Marauder's Guild. So, okay, what is behind there? And what is... Why do they need to keep it secret from you, a member of the guild? Is that just where they keep all the free housing and ponies and, you know, erotic massages? Is that what they're hiding from us? Is that what they don't want us to know? Why is the E backwards? That just bothers me. So, stop going in and out of that lady.
I Wandering. I know who you are. My brother often has me escort his fledgling marauders on their most dangerous tasks.
Yes, he's my brother, but I didn't know that when I started talking with this accent. Suppose Renzo expects me to give you the details, then. Very well. It seems the farmers need us to clear out a megalocrab nest near the Mourning Widow in Lower Lanoska. I shall trust you to find your own way there. Just don't forget your axe.
Oh my god, can we just talk about her robes for a second? She had fucking leopard print wizard robes. That's amazing. Oh my god, this whole family. It's just so extra. It's just the embodiment of the 100 emoji. See right here, when we click on the Tempest Gate, just teleported directly to Lower Lanoska. Lanoska? Lanoscia? Lanoskia? Bob? Las Vegas? I really like that cliff face here. I don't have anything funny to say about it. It's just very pretty. And those are some big frogs. Do we have to kill them? No, it seems like we don't. But we have to kill these ghost jellyfish scrotum things. Because just look at it. I mean, don't look that close to it. No kind god would create such a thing. I mean, it's pretty, but in a very kind of abomination-y way. I like, too, that you can just kill one of these things, and all the other ones will watch you do it. But, you know, they won't help. Like, not my problem, Gary. Not my problem. Just stay out of it. She'll leave us alone. It's a nice formation. I like that they put, like, a little stone wall around it. I don't know why. I don't think it can actually be reinforcing it. It's just there to look official, you know? Like, hey, we're not just guarding this stone archway. What? I'm sorry, Clam is just saying a bunch of zeros here. The eyes. Oh. Shit, I couldn't even see that. I didn't even see that. Oh, yeah. It is clearly a pair of eyes. I mean, it's no face on Mars or no old man of the mountain, but it's... It sure was nice of whatever natural forces just, you know, carve that... I don't know. I'm out. Out of words. Take a shot every time I run out of words. It's a new official drinking game. I've just made it canon. Anyway, we have to go fight something called a megalocrab. That sounds like a pleasant afternoon. Okay, come on. I can't tell if you're doing... If they're doing all the work and you're finishing them off, or if they're just pathetic and you're just one-shotting all these guys. Oh yeah, I think you guys can have it. Oh no, wait, one of them is kind of dead. Yep, okay, all your backup is gone. Great, you're a real hero. You truly are the champion of the downtrodden, Wandering Clam. Oh my god, so much pink on that girl. Mittens meow. Oh, how precious. I don't even know. I have no words for that. Let's read some flavor text here. When the wheat farmers of Lower Lanoska were losing large portions of their crops to locusts, they turned to Melvin's Gate, who introduced I know that's an actual word, but I don't... And I don't know how to pronounce it. Sildales cane toads to the fields to devour the Valken. Unfortunately, the cane toads, who have no natural predators on Vilbrand, have taken over the region, leaving the farms with no choice but to slay them all. Okay, so it's basically like Australia and rabbits then. So there's one down there. Kill it. Oh, don't worry. We'll just introduce gorillas to take care of our cane toads. And when winter happens, the gorillas just freeze to death. Okay, so fighting a megalocrab. Looks as if nobody's home. Mayhap they knew we were coming. Aid! I need aid! Oh god, no. Not... Ed Stark's gonna die. Please. It's my grandson. Them snippers got him. I told Sigurd not to get too close. I told him! Get that weapon ready, Wandering. We need to move. Now.
Susie, leopard print wizard robes. That's amazing.
Okay, that certainly is a megalo crab.
A lot of the important battles here are instanced, which means, you know, they're taking place in a game world where only you can access them.
Keeps other people from stealing your boss skills.
Oh, bugger my asshole! Get away from me, you bloody great bastard!
And then he died from crabs, or... No?
Oh my god! Are you my new mother?
And the conjurer's lady just like, go on, you can take him. I got your back from way back here.
So apparently these giant toads have no predator, which, you know, leads them to overrun the ecology. But then... there's these giant enemy crabs.
I said the meme.
Who live in like this, who live like right next door to them. And, you know, they're apparently carnivorous, apparently malicious, and yet they do nothing against the evil toad menace.
Look out! It's a crab battle!
Oh my god, they're just swarming all over each other.
Things twice your level, Wandering. What are you doing here?
Just let the NPC take care of it.
That's what she exists for.
I mean, she's not doing that good of a job, but...
Oh, what the... Where do these things keep coming from? Where'd Broenbar get here from? Is he gonna have a jetpack?
I mean, you know, on the plus side... I bet all this crab is going to taste delicious once we roast it, or boil it, or fry it.
Well, I don't really know what you do to crab.
Oh my god, how many waves of these are there? Why are we in horde mode for crab? Ow. I just hit my own headphones. Just reverberating in my ear.
Hey, thank you, miss. I thought I was dead for sure. I can't even play outside no more. What with all these scary monsters about? My mom, my dad, they both killed by some nasty bugger so long ago. An aurochs, big as a mountain. But I bet you could beat it. I make it pay for what it did to my folks. You take it easy now, son. There's a whole guild full of strapping lads and lasses like Wandering here who'll be glad to do just that. All you need to do is head home with your grandpa. You'll let us worry about that big, nasty bugger.
Do what the nice lady says. You'll get such a smack when you get home.
Consider your first duty a success, Wandering. It's time you headed back as well. Before Windzone begins to worry, I've left your corpse for the crabs. Again.
I mean, it's happened maybe 5, 6 times, you know. I'm not very good at my job.
I'm just supposed to stand back and let them take it. And then they die. They just get completely snipped open by the crabs and all the guts are hanging out. Oh, it's disgusting. But you can't look away from it.
Quick, come in at the right minute and just steal credit. Oh, it's Mittens Meow again.
So I melt with you. I love that. I stop the world and melt with you. I've seen the difference, but it's getting better all the time.
Once again, you're watching Wandering Eorzea with Captain Sarcasm and Wandering Clam. And we just killed an assload of crabs. Go us.
You know, one good thing... Well, it's a bad thing about the early part of the game.
As you go on, it gets more and more trivial to get around to places. You got sprinting right now, you'll have mounts and flying mounts later. And if you save up all your money, you'll be able to just, like, blow hundreds of gil on teleportation fees like it's nothing. I mean, more than being able to kill things, just being able to get around the map in a matter of seconds, that makes me feel, you know, like a true hero. Because much like in D&D games, gives a shit about travel time. You want to get to the action. You get one random battle along the way, but no more. So you shattered the shells of the megalocrabs and saved the life of a child into the bargain. Oh, thus does our violent craft prove its merit. Well done, Wandering.
She's a marauder too? Oh my god.
You two are going to be partners now. You two are in a buddy cop movie, the mismatched team of a giant roga and a pink cat girl. Though no longer a threat to the farmers. You should know that it is unusual for such crabs to be found so near the stead. By all accounts, the creatures were ousted from their usual feeding grounds by a more fierce beast. The beast of which I speak is a known terror in the lands of Lanoska. Ever seeking to expand its territory, Mittens Meow is just looking directly at the camera while she changes her clothes and it freaks me out. And that boy's parents were but two of the many victims to fall to its rampages. It is a threat that must be dealt with ere long. Do thoughts of vengeance flit through your mind, Wandering? Nurture those urges, but do not yet act on them. This monstrosity is far beyond your present skills. If you would answer the lad's cry for revenge, then you must become stronger. Become the raging behemoth that this challenge demands.
Sweet, we got a new axe, and we get some new shit. And it's the same as our old axe. Okay, what do we want here? Looks like that's the only new thing. Let's get it. Oh yeah, it's a nice look. It's very, it's almost kind of faux Napoleonic. If only, I mean, it would be great though if your pants were just like just a shade of red different. Like just be like a walking cherry tomato. And we're back here, apparently. Soon we're going to be doing some more hunting, maybe. One thing I love about this game is the art design, you know? You could never get into World of Warcraft because of how cartoony it felt. It never felt like a world I could get invested in. It felt like, I don't know, somebody had taken a real fantasy world and just opened up like a whole thing of crayons and scribbled all over it, and then ripped off the shoulder pads from Warhammer 40,000. But this actually feels so much more real, and without being like dipping into real as brown, because look at it, there's color everywhere. There's greens and blues and, you know, bright light and stupid outfits, and look at that, lens flares and gorgeous vistas. I mean, most people take realism to be like that recent Fantastic Four movie, wherein realism means we can't afford lights. I mean, look at it. This creates a world you just want to live in. You want to be a part of it. And you want to go and find new things in it to kill. Now, here it is. We left Stalewyrn hanging.
Ah, Clam. That aura of confidence tells me you've not been idle since last we met. I hope I've read you all right, for I have a task that requires the attention of a capable adventurer. Might that adventurer be you? I mean, I would hope so. You're like the only one who's come by. Ah, good to hear. That's what you said, right? I assume so. I shall lay before you the sorry tale. You will have heard rumors of the abductions. Aye, citizens have been disappearing from every corner of Limsa Lamimsa, as if plucked from the face of Hydlin, boots and all, by an unseen hand.
They didn't even leave the boots with a little wisp of smoke behind. That's some powerful magic. And what's this got to do with Summerford Farms, you might ask? Well, I ain't got the fuckest idea. But, you know, it seems a collection of nigh unsavory fellows with azure tattooed faces have been creeping up to the edge of the fields and spying on my yeomen. Now, I doubt anyone would enjoy being scrutinized by such savages at the best of times. But the farmhands are convinced that the kidnappers come for their hides. And needless to say, they behide themselves with worry and work suffering for it. And I mean, these guys were lazy enough. You know, we don't need anything more keeping us from getting our work done. Do you know how I have to do everything around here and nobody appreciates that?
I just want someone to say thank you sometimes. I try to be a good... I mean,
so, would you be willing to investigate those tattooed thugs for me?
It's a good loss. The sooner we get to the bottom of this, the sooner this place will start to resemble a working farm again.
Actually, I suggest
you begin by having a look around Seasong Grotto. If reports are to be believed, our unwelcome visitors have occupied the place. Be careful, though, Clam. I couldn't say for what manner of miscreants we're dealing with here. If they are the kidnappers, well, just be on your guard, all right?
Okay. So actually, now that I'm done talking about realism, I do have to say one thing. How in any way is this a farm? I mean, look at it. It's on a hill. There's just rocks and trees and wandering monsters everywhere. This is terrible farmland. Okay, yeah, they have an orchard. An orchard is not a farm, okay? That's totally different words. I mean, a vineyard is not a farm either. Don't get cocky with me. I mean, I guess it is a matter of, you know, being an RPG. You can't create, like, a whole farm with just, you know, several square miles of fields and cotton, but, you know, the wheat and stuff. But, you know, still, they could at least, they could try a little bit harder. Seriously, how are you going to plow a slope? It's just asking for trouble. Okay, some ruins here. That's always a good sign. Oh my god, look at that! Look at that, they got little clefairies wandering around here. Oh, they're so cute. They got little ear wings and little squiggly pigtails, and we're gonna kill them. They don't even have faces! Oh my god. I can't tell if that's good or bad. I got some bitchin' like nipple tats. But no faces. Who is keeping track of these? Are you just bringing their heads back to the guild off camera? Because that would be cool, actually. I'd like it if there was just a steadily developing wall of all the, you know, just showing the heads of everything you kill on your hunt. Yeah, that would be sweet. Okay. So now let's check out this place that's obviously not a trap. Look at it. It's just... You just murdered some of them, and it's just so happy to be here. More people are going to come and murder them, because the life of a monster is pain. You know what? I'm sure that someone somewhere could read that, but that someone is not me.
I am the waves that bear. I am the winds that guide. I am the evening stars. I am the morning sky. I am born of the sea, and there... shall I die?
Thanks, Internet. I didn't have to do work.
I am the waves that bear.
They actually say it.
I am the evening stars. I am the morning sky.
It's been a long time since I've played this. I don't remember every detail. Keep going.
Shall I die? Thus reads the sailor's requiem. Hmm.
Thus reads the sailor's requiem carved into yonder stone.
Hello, I'm sure you won't be important later. Are you saying there is voice, or should I do her voice? Okay.
Such words well describe the manner in which the citizens of Limsa Luminsa live their lives. It is both a litany against misfortune for those out on the waves, and a prayer that the souls of those who perish on land might find their way back to the sea. Ah, you are the adventurer I've seen around Summerford Farms. I thought myself on the trail of the kidnappers, but it would seem I have missed my mark. Or perhaps not.
I'm sorry, that thing...
The etheric disturbance here is no natural occurrence. Nor is it a coincidence that the two of us should come here in search of those responsible for the disappearances, only to be attacked.
Jesus, those teeth!
Of the secret
thoughts must wait. Let us attend to the task at hand, unpleasant though it be.
So, it's very difficult for me to tell when people are actually talking in the cutscenes. So, okay, I'm guessing no chance of getting the missing people back alive. Unless this thing is just completely unrelated, which, I mean, it might be. The quests do tend to ramble. But yeah, I just love how something that looks like a big, dumb, docile jelly bean could just have, like, this mouth just full of huge teeth. It's kind of like the most dangerous animal in all of Africa, the hippopotamus, which kills more humans than any other creature. I'm not kidding, look it up. Do not fuck with a hippo. It will murder you. It's like a tank that also eats you. I like how this guy just ignores the woman hitting him with an axe and goes for the tiny, tiny little cat girl. Oh, good. More of them. That's... I love the way they look at you like, hey, what's going on here? Do we be fighting this guy? I'm gonna fight this guy. Oh, their arms are so rubbery. It's like they don't have any bones in them. They may not have bones. I don't know if they have bones. Yeah, that's right. Just attack it right in the ass. Just jam that axe right in there. Listen, why is he not turning around? I mean, I'm grateful that you can get, like, the backstab bonus, but... If someone was behind me hitting me with an axe, I would notice. It would be the focus of all my attention. Look, he just won't die. He's just hanging on for dear life to those hit points. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, thank God it fell forward. Blah, 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 blah.
Is there a voice now? Still?
Ooh. Well, this looks important. I'm sure that's the kind of thing you just find lying randomly in a cave.
Oh, shit. Oh, what was that crystal cut with?
The lighting is exceptional, really. Oh, that can't be good. I like how the eye patch just disappears into the hair. Somebody forgot to model.
Crystal bearer.
Oh no, it's a sun crusher! Kip Duron's gonna blow up a star with that.
A light there once was that shone throughout this realm, yet it has since grown dim. And as it hath faltered, so hath darkness risen up in its stead, presaging an end to life. For the sake of all, I beseech thee, deliver us from this fate.
I don't want to talk over anything, but I have so many things.
The power to banish the darkness dwelleth in the crystals of light. Journey forth.
Ooh.
And lay claim to them.
Yeah, and... So I like that all this is going on. She's on this weird mystical crystal drug trip, but yet she has no questions or reactions and doesn't even change her expression. She is just taking this all in stride. So I think our friend Wandering here has some experience with recreational hallucinogens. You see, the lighting, though, is just incredible. It almost looks like a pre-rendered cutscene, but it's very hard to do fog like that. Whee!
Whee!
Can I fly as well? Can I do that? Think happy thoughts! Da, da. So, are those just like random nobodies? Do we ever meet those people we saw again?
My child, and shine thy light on all creatures.
It would be great if you could just run into other people and be like, "Oh my god, I remember you from that shared hallucination."
Awake again, are we?
Is their voice now? Okay.
Aha! The poor creature's fury was kindled with cruel forethought. See this blade? I found it in the Goobbue's back.
Ooh, nasty!
I've seen knives of this kind before. They are most commonly used for the cutting of rope.
I mean, yeah, it's a knife. You use it to cut things.
Culprits are seafaring men of some persuasion. Piratical being the most probable.
I like how she can see this knife and just knows what it cuts.
Affliction. I confess, I was rather taken aback when you collapsed at the very moment of our victory. Mayhap a surfeit of ether? A towering crystal. I'm sure I don't. Well, well. This has been a day of unexpected revelations. I must continue my investigation. In the meantime, I suggest you deliver this knife to your patron, along with a warning concerning the pirate's probable involvement in this murky business. The days ahead promise little rest, I fear. May our paths cross again, under the light of the crystal.
And we'll never see her again. Okay, well, that happened. And I think that's where we'll need to end our wanderings for tonight. So wait, don't log out just yet. So I'd like to say thank you, everyone, for watching. And please continue to support Wandering Through Eorzea and our hopefully upcoming show, That's So Dark Souls. Bear Lust. Okay, that's a note we want to go out on. Bear Lust from the Arrows Guild. That's